The first time I remember kind of being interested in space was when I was 7 years old and my dad bought me a telescope. And then one night we got a glimpse of Saturn's rings just for a few seconds. And I remember it feeling almost like the moment that Galileo must have felt, like, oh my God, that's out there. And over the course of years, I still had that interest, that fascination. What UCLA has done is allowed me to take my love for medicine and my love for science and put them together. It's been a dream come true. I'm Dr. Haig Aintablian. I'm an emergency physician here at UCLA and the inaugural space medicine fellow. There are very few fields where you can say that there's a new frontier, and this is one of them. You know, we're subjecting humans to things that they've never been subjected to before. So space medicine is essentially taking the medical field and adapting it for long duration space travel. We're not designed for space. You know, we're designed for this 1G environment with a nice atmosphere, with breathable oxygen, not in a vacuum. We have all these things here that we've evolved to be able to do. As soon as you put a human out in space or, you know, a microgravity environment, you start to see a whole host of physiological effects. Our goal with space medicine is to make sure that these missions that happen, that take us to the moon and to Mars, lead to as little human harm as possible. My UCLA Emergency Medicine Residency Program is probably one of the best decisions I made in my life. Our fellowship is the first emergency medicine-based space medicine fellowship with the goal of, you know, creating not only doctors in mission control, but also doctors that potentially go up to space. UCLA has kind of opened so many doors, not only just with rotations that we do for this fellowship, but also with the entire health system. UCLA has a pretty robust helicopter transport team, and our goal with this helicopter transport team is to take patients that are super sick at another hospital where they don't have the resources to take care of them and transfer them safely to our hospital, even when they're critically ill. And my job is to make sure that they survive that flight so that our experts can take care of them here. And I know just how stressful, you know, things are. I know how many hours we train, how much hardship we see, how much death even we see. And you're still expected to function during those difficult moments. I had a moment where there was a 101-year-old lady that came to the emergency department not doing very well. I quickly got in touch with the patient's son, and he was fairly far away. He said, if you could do anything to keep her alive so I could say my goodbye. And as soon as he came in, she passed away 2 minutes later. And so it's moments like these where you really realize that you have a huge impact on people's lives. UCLA has been a hallmark, especially as a public institution, in making sure that LA is better taken care of. I know how difficult it is to become a physician, but being where I am now, I think I really am living the dream, and I'm so thankful for it.